recorded a video in quite a few weeks. It's been really, really busy around here, but I am really excited about this. I have had this package waiting on me for at least a month and a half, maybe 2 months, and it's eyeshadow. So it's something I've really been excited to get into, and every time I pass this package on my door, no, not doorstep, that would have been way too long, on my dining room table, sorry, my puppy was messing with my cat and they were under the table, it's always something, but anyway, so every time I've passed this box on my dining room table, it's just been calling to me, it's been a siren's song, saying, open me. I don't even remember the deal that I got. Well, let me back up from all of that. This is from Colourpop. They were running a special I saw on Facebook that was either 15 eyeshadows for $20 or 20 eyeshadows for $15. I don't know. It was one of those middle of the night things, scrolling, and I was like, oh, I love eyeshadow. I love Colourpop. Match made in heaven. And now, as excited as I was about it, as I am about it, it's just been sitting on my table for a really long time waiting for me to open it. So here we are. Welcome. I hope you are as excited as I am. I did come prepared this time with some little cotton pads, iPads, whatever, for swatches. So I think in one of the last videos I did, I said I was going to do swatches, and like a quarter of the way in, got really excited about the makeup and totally forgot to do swatches. So hopefully today I will not. I will have this staring right at me to remind me. Swatch. That's what you're here for. Well, part of what you're here for. So this is actually a pretty good size box. It came in relatively quickly. Colourpop doesn't have the fastest shipping, at least to my address, but within like 2 weeks. Really cute box though. Says, I'm made of post-consumer recycled materials. Reuse or recycle me. And I'm all about that. So, love to see it. My daughter will probably take the box. She's always asking for more storage in her room, which that's a whole other argument. So, let's see if we can get into this without getting an injury. And I know for me, I don't usually enjoy single eyeshadows. These are the super shock shadows. I have a hard time saying that. Because it just becomes a storage issue. I end up tossing them in a drawer and then kind of forgetting about them. So I also got a little acrylic holder. And I looked through several places on Amazon, and I read the reviews because I don't know what the measurements are, and I have one super shock shadow upstairs, and I'm not going to sit there and measure the component, although that would be the smart way to go, but a couple of people for this particular storage one did mention that it fits the super shock shadows. This is going to be a long video, I'm sorry. So we'll see. We'll see if they were right. Hopefully they are. We'll be whatever tints you want to use on it. So let me set this here, and let's get into the box, shall we? We shall. I have rambled on about nonsense long enough, so here we go. I'm gonna give you first look, because we're friends and that's what friends do. That's what I do. Bubble wrap! No, that means it was packaged really well. Let's see. I know what it is, but I don't know how it's packaged in here. Okay. sure if that was just the topper that would fly off or what. So let's see, where can I set that? My everything behind here is a total mess. Ooh, organization, who is she? We don't know her, so. On the back it says, shock it to me. Okay, so let's open that up, shall we? Maybe. Maybe not. Okay, here we go. I feel it coming, you guys. It's coming. Maybe not. One layer at a time, we're getting there. Okay, and pop. Colourpop, shock it to me. So let's see, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, so 12 shadows for $20. I was wrong on both memories. Have the names of them on the back here, and I'm sure on the back of the shadows themselves, but let's see, we have Mountain Lion, 3rd Street, 2014, I should probably start with it, The Griffith, Low 70s, Life's Coach, Aster, Kombucha, Green Juice, 405, right there, Born in L.A., and adaptogen, right there. You guys should know by now, my animals are out walking around doing goodness knows what, so if you hear them, sorry. Not a whole lot I can do about that. Those of us who have four-legged children know they kind of do what they want to do. It is really well packaged though. It's very cute. It has a nice little plastic. And on the back here it does say that ColourPop is cruelty free, which we love to see. Let's get comfortable and get swatching and see what we have. So let's, oh, perfect. Kind of. I don't recall. Okay. I'm going to set up my little code here on the back to see what we have color wise. But I'm sure it says it on the containers themselves as well, though. Let's see if we can get these out. Ooh, I would have been off and running in the wrong direction. I'm glad it does say on the back. So this is the Super Shock Shadow in the color 2014. Ooh, that's pretty. It's a neutral. Kind of sparkly. Let's take a little swatch here and see what we. I wish I could remember. I didn't think about bringing down the one I already have, but this one seems very similar. Kind of a champagne-y gold, which is right up my alley. A little bit sheer. But for a topper, it's very pretty. Where are we? There we go. Very shiny, very reflective. I'm wearing the one Super Shock shadow that I do have on the center of my eyelids today. Maybe I'll put it in the description down below what it is I have. Not that it matters, but it's fun to know. So this is 2014. Very pretty. And again, it's right there. And let's see. It does fit. Hooray. So this one holds quite a few, so.
Room to grow.
This container holds, let's see. Been a while since I've been in school, but I do remember that. So next, Super Shock Shadow we have is Third Street. And this says it is an Ultra Glitter. 2014 is also an Ultra Glitter. So this one looks like it's more cream colored than the champagne of the 2014. Maybe I'll show them side by side in their containers as well. What if they don't show the difference? A little bit, but I don't know if it'll show up in on camera the difference. No, it doesn't. We have 2014 and 3rd Street here. It's really hard to see the difference even in person between the two. This one is the 2014, a little bit darker. And this one is the 3rd Street, so a little bit lighter. But very pretty, very neutral, great toppers. I love it, love to see it, I'm here for it. This one I think should be Mountain Lion. It is Mountain Lion, and this is the whitest of them all. On this line and in general. This is also a Super Shock Shadow and Ultra Glitter. I don't know if all these are Ultra Glitter or not. I really don't remember, so we will find out. I wonder if this could also be used as a highlighter. Ooh, interesting. So here, it looks white, but it is iridescent in a duochrome, and it comes across as very pink, which is really nice. Personally, I wouldn't use it as a highlighter for that reason. I think you can see it there. That is kind of a pinky reflect. Very pretty though. Do really nice on the eyes. So let's wipe those off. This is the Alme Makeup Free Zone. A little cotton pad. I guess that would do well for like removing makeup around your eyes, but your whole face, it would take forever. Alright. Yeah, there's nothing there from the Mountain Lion, but the 2014. I guess it's a little bit darker than the 3rd Street. Not substantially, but it is just a topper, I think. So enough. Always gives me a little bit of trouble to go back on. I'm not going to worry about it because I'll be in and out of it the whole video. So, first row down. And now for the second row. And if I'm continuing in this path, this one should be the Griffith, yes. My own fault. I'm apparently going in a different direction now. This is the Super Shock Shadow Ultra Metallic in Life Coach. It's a nice gold metallic. My puppy's walking in now, so who knows what kind of background noises we're going to get. That is beautiful, though. Christmas is coming up in the next 5 months, but we actually have a concert my daughter and I are going to, so this will be really nice if I can figure out a way to make it work with my neutral looks. So here it is on the finger, and swatched. I don't know if I would call that ultra metallic, actually. It's pretty be sheer. It's as sheer as the other ones were. That's a little bit disappointing. I mean, it's still very pretty, but when I think ultra metallic, I'm like, one stripe and bam, in your face, not super sheer. Then this one should be low 70s. And again, with the Life Coach one that we just had, that is very much a me color, and I will wear it a whole lot. But again, for an ultra metallic, I don't know if I would call it that. This one is the Super Shock Shadow Ultra Glitter Low 70s. In person, it's kind of a very faint burgundy. I don't know if it's coming across, it looks kind of brown there. Which, yeah, I guess a faint burgundy is, but a more, kind of like a faded brick color. I'll call it that, I guess. See if that changes it. Maybe, yeah, faded brick. And let's see, swatch here. Well, yeah, I didn't say ultra metallic on this one. It was ultra glitter, so there it is on my fingers. Kind of the color of the box, actually. Again, really pretty though. Not really showing up there. It's kind of there. Yeah. That one was an ultra glitter. Super Shock Shadow. Low 70s is that color. So this one should be the Griffith. Let's see if I'm right. One is the Super Shock Shadow Ultra Glitter, the Griffith. Ooh, it's kind of a mauve color, purpley mauve. And again, that's an ultra glitter, so let's see what we get. That one seems to have the most pigment of all of them. It might be a duochrome. That would be exciting. The Griffiths. A little bit. It's kind of a wonder. Does that help? Oh, that does not help. Okay. Kind of a purpley sheer. And those are on the fingers. We have Life Coach. Low 70s and the Griffith on there. I've been thinking, what kind of videos do you guys want? I was kind of contemplating doing like a makeup role play. I know I personally, those are my favorite ones to watch. I could try something like that. Obviously, if you look back on my channel, I've not done anything like that. Because I am still fairly new and trying to figure things out, so. I don't know if you guys are tired of like the swatches and the blind bags and things like that. I really enjoy them. But, you know, we're here for everybody, so it's not just about what I like. But if you guys want to try like a makeup role play, I'll be happy to do that or give it a shot and we'll see how we go from there. You know, or any other kind of role play, maybe we could talk about it, certainly have a conversation. I'm open to suggestions, and again, always open to constructive criticism. So, let me know what's on your mind. So the first two rows are done, and I've been wrong both times on the starting color. Let's see if I can figure it out this time. This is a really pretty green. I should be able to figure this out. This line has, I'm assuming, if I'm right, green juice, kombucha, and ester. Let's see if I'm right. So I think we're going to start with green juice, if I'm right. I'm right. Green juice, ultra metallic. As you can see, green is my favorite color. I just don't wear a lot on my eyes because I do have green eyes. And I've always heard that if you want green eyes to pop, you should wear like a purple or a blue. Opposite on the color wheel. This is very pretty though. It's almost like a metallic-y pea green. Or a mossy green. Very pretty. Ooh, it's soft. Softest one yet. I was not prepared for that. It's a lot more vibrant in person. That is a swatch. Ultra metallic, yes, that I believe. More so than the other one we had. That was more of a sheer. Well, again, I haven't swatched it yet, so we'll see. That one shows up. Boom. You may not be able to see the color, but you can definitely see by the opaque of the swatch. It showed up a lot more, and there's still a lot on my finger. That's really pretty. So this one is kombucha. And this is an ultra glitter, super shock shadow. I was about to say, I don't really wear a lot of this color, but I'm literally wearing kind of an orangey brown today. So I guess I do. This is a glittery, so we'll see. That's like tangerine orange. That's really bright. It's also very soft. Okay, I can deal with this. Again, it's kind of a salmon-y orange on the swatch. Peachy orange, maybe. So let's see. Alright, it's fine. It's really sheer. It'd be a good topper to get a little bit of sparkle, but so far most of these are along that vein and in that color line, so. This is really pretty, though. This one is Aster Super Shock Shadow Ultra Glitter. This is more of a taupe, neutral, that I am here for and about. So when I get done swatching these and showing them, I think I'm going to kind of group them into the ones that I think are the most similar. Let's see what we get. Yeah, nothing really to write home about. So we have green juice, kombucha, and aster. And I say that all of these are really pretty. They are beautiful, they're soft, they swatch well, but they're also, a lot of them are very similar, so I don't know if I would have purchased all of these individually, if that makes sense, because why buy four of the same shadows, you know, or some very similar. So here's Aster here, kombucha, and green juice. Very pretty. They all swatch really nicely, they're very shiny. Along the same lines of pretty much all the same colors, you know. Let me see if I can get them to show up on the makeup remover pad. Yeah, that works. So you can kind of see them a little better there. The green juice is here. Kombucha and aster. So very, very pretty, but very, very similar. I'm 1 for 3 right now on getting these correct in their orders. I think I finally figured the pattern out though. So I think this one is going to be Adaptogen here. Born in LA and then 405. So I'm hopeful for these three. I think these three are going to be the darkest and most pigmented of the set so far. Well, so far. Last three. The good news is, though, is that none of these are like the one that I already have, so that's exciting. I have some of their Super Shock blushes, but I didn't like that one as much. I don't think I had the right kind of brush for it, and it didn't really work out for me, which is a shame. I love blushes, too. Oh, this one is 405. I'm so sorry. I forgot to guess. But to be fair, I was going to say Adaptogen, so... I would have been wrong anyway. 405. This is really pretty. This is like a purpley color. This is the Ultra Glitter. So we'll see. It's like a really deep maroon purple. I think if you were going to do like a mermaid look, this would be beautiful if it shows up that deep. It does on the swatch on the finger. really nice. Let's see. Yes. Finally. That's what I'm looking for. That is color. And again, of all of them, I don't know how much I would wear this because it is so in-your-face color. Even in person, it's really glittery. Really glittery. It's beautiful. But I would really have to convince myself to use it. I'm afraid if I use something like this, it just looks like I got punched in the eye and have a nice big black eye. But it is so pretty. I'm going to have to be brave one day and wear that. I can't not have that in my collection or not wear it. Okay, so that one is Born in LA. This one is also a Super Shock Shadow Ultra Metallic. This one looks kind of coppery. I have, like I said, I have the most hope for these three as being most opaque and in your face color, and even they're very wearable colors. Yes, so pretty. Halloween is coming. Look at that. My daughter and I went to breakfast this morning and found Halloween while we were out and about, and I was so happy. So happy. Bought a couple of things, even though it's only July. She's my little Halloween buddy, so we go and go shopping for Halloween when we can. And this one is Adaptogen. You guys, it's been a real long day. When I was pulling it out, I almost said 405. No. It is not 405. This is Adaptogen. Super Shock Shadow Ultra Metallic Adaptogen. We'll get it right eventually, right? Well, I should hope so. It's the last one. If I can't get it right now, I'm going to be in deep trouble. And this one's kind of a, I almost said dirty brown, but that doesn't make a lot of sense. A muddy brown, maybe. It's my puppy walking around. It's really pretty, though. It's beautiful. I would absolutely wear the Everlovin' Mess out of this one. Oh, that's nice. It's like a bronze. That's probably the best way to say that. Give that all to me, please. Yes. There we go. That's nice. I'm the happiest, I think, with this last line of colors. All right. So let me wipe these off. And let me see which three or which ones I think are the most similar. Because there were definitely ones that were... There are definitely some where if you're looking for one but can't find it, kind of dupes for one another. That were very similar, and I think if they're on the eyes and kind of blended out, you'd never be able to tell the difference. I don't know, there's so many colors out where it's like, I don't have a problem duping one for the other because again, for my eyeshadow or my eyelid space anyway, it's so small. No one is ever going to get up that close in my face and be like, I'm sorry, are you wearing this color from this company? I'm like, if you are, respectfully back up. It's just, I don't know. Anyway, let me see which colors we have that are very similar and kind of give you, I'll see if I can figure out which one's my favorite. And you let me know which one's your favorite. We'll be right back. So I think I have four that are very similar, three that are very similar, and then five that are kind of standalone ones. So really, all in all, it's not a bad collection. I'm happy I got it. I'm happy with the price that I paid for it, and I'm happy I'm finally doing this video so I can open it up, look at them, play with them, and actually start wearing them. Some of them. I may have to... be brave. That's the word I was thinking of. It's not even the word I was thinking of, but anyway, talk myself into it because they're going to be beautiful and they're going to be really nice on the eyes. I'm just very neutral. Anyway, so I think Mountain Lion Ultra Glitter, 2014 Ultra Glitter, and Third Street Ultra Glitter. And last one here, Life Coach Ultra Metallic. these are going to be very similar. Let's see, this one is 3rd Street. And I think these are, in my opinion, they would all be like toppers, or if you want to go for a little bit of a no makeup, makeup look, these could work as a single shadow on the eyes. So there's that one. That one again is 3rd Street. This one is 2014. I'm gonna sound like an old person here for a minute, but I can't believe 2014 was almost 10 years ago. So we have 3rd Street, 2014, side by side here. 3rd Street, right? Yes. 3rd Street, right here. 2014, right here. Again, real neutral. Would go really nicely over whatever you have underneath it. Then we have Life Coach Ultra Metallic. Right here. Yeah, these are pretty similar. A little bit different, but not much at all. It's like a very light, 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 light gold. And then this one's a little bit different than the other three, but I think it's sheer enough that on the eyes, nobody really knows the difference. This one is Mountain Lion Ultra Glitter. It's really pretty. It looks white, but I think if I recall correctly, it swatches like a pink. Almost like an opal. Yeah, opal color. Very nice. You kind of see the four on there. Very similar. Again, once they're on the eyes, I think they would just all into the same. And then I'm not going to swatch the last five because I've already swatched these, but I want to kind of give you an idea of the ones that I feel like are the same or very similar, kind of what they are compared to one another. This one is the Super Shock Shadow Ultra Glitter Low 70s. So these are the next three that I think are very similar in the bunch. Like a glittery pink. It's very pretty though. I will say I like Colourpop's glitters. They're very finely milled. You don't get, you know, a piece of glitter stuck in your eye halfway through the day. It's really nice. And I don't ever really get a lot of fallout from these either. So there's that one. Low 70s right there. It's very pretty. Kombucha. Super Glitter. Nope. Super Shock Shadow Ultra Glitter. This one's kind of that orangey, tangerine-y color that ends up being swatched out to not much at all. Yeah, these are so similar. The low 70s has a bit more pink to it, but really, in person, on the eyes and blended out, I wouldn't be able to really tell the difference. Some people might, and good for them. I'm not one of those people. I would just be like, oh, that's pretty. Okay. And the third of this bunch is the Aster Super Shock Shadow Ultra Glitter. These are already getting messy. White packaging. So there's the three of them on the fingers. Very similar colors. Yeah. I think the last two are more similar than the low 70s. But again, on the eyes, extremely similar. So that was good. And that leaves, like I said, I'm not going to swatch the last five because we've already swatched them all, but this one is the Griffith, kind of a purpley color. That's very pretty. This one is the Green Juice, kind of a chartreuse lime green color. Very, 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 very pretty. Born in L.A., kind of a copper color, really nice, deep, opaque. 405, that kind of a bright purple color. green eyes, apparently. That's what I always heard anyway. And then this one is the adaptogen, kind of the bronze color, if I remember correctly. That one. This one might be my favorite because it's very much like a color I would wear on the day-to-day to kind of deepen up the outer V. And, good news, they do fit really nicely. I have room to grow. The one I have can fit in there too still. So that's really nice rather than just floating around on my vanity like it does now. So yeah, that was that. Thank you so much, everyone, for all the positivity, the likes, the comments, the constructive criticism. Keep it coming, please, please. I appreciate every one of you, and I hope you, yes, you have a really wonderful night, and I hope you sleep well, and I will see you next.